Hi everybody, welcome to Storytime with Fairfield County Library. My name is Messina and I am so excited for Storytime today. Are you guys ready? Okay, awesome. This week our theme is siblings. That means this week we're going to read books that are about brothers and sisters. Okay, our first book is The New Small Person by Lauren Child, published by Candlewick Press. Elmore Green started off life as an only child, as many children do. He had a room all to himself, and everything in it was his. He was very proud of his room. He watched all his favorite cartoons on his own little TV set. No one ever changed the channel. He could line up all his precious things on the floor, and no one moved them one inch. When his Uncle Cecil gave him a jar of jelly beans, Elmore could eat every single bean all by himself, in whatever order he liked. There was no need to worry about anyone eating the orange ones because Elmore Green's parents did not eat jelly beans. Elmore Green's parents thought he was simply the funniest, cleverest, most adorable person they had ever seen. And Elmore Green liked that because it is nice to be the funniest, cleverest, most adorable person someone has ever seen. But then one day, everything changed. Somebody else came along. The new person was small and didn't do much, but still, people picked it up and smiled at it and gave it things to chew. They all seemed to like it. Maybe a little bit more than they liked Elmore Green. The new small person didn't like watching Elmore Green's favorite TV cartoons and would squawk until the channel was changed. Elmore did not find shows for small people all that stimulating. But everyone said that the small person couldn't help it because it was only small. Sometimes the small person would come into Elmore's room and knock things over and sit on things that didn't want to be sat on. Once it actually licked Elmore's jelly bean collection, including the orange ones. As anyone knows, jelly beans that have been licked are not nearly so nice. But everyone said Elmore could not be angry because the small person was only small. Elmore Green wished the small person would go back to wherever it came from. The Elmore's parents explained that this was not possible. The small person got bigger and things got much worse. One day, Elmore found the small person wearing his fourth most favorite outfit, without asking. "That's mine," said Elmore. "It's not for small people." "I want to be the same as you," said the small person. but Elmore Green did not want to be the same as someone small. The small person followed Elmore Green everywhere. It wanted to sit next to him. It wanted to copy everything that Elmore did. It wanted to be everywhere that Elmore was. "Where are you going, Elmore?" said the small person.
"Nowhere," said Elmore.
"Can I come?" said the small person. When the small person said things like this, Elmore Green would go and sit up a tree. He did not want someone small following him around. One awful day, the small person moved its bed into Gilmore Green's room. Now Elmore couldn't get away from it. It was always there looking at him. Sometimes it would stretch out its arms and say, "Huggle!" But Elmore didn't want to cuddle up to someone small. However, one night, everything changed. Elmore Green had a bad dream. It was very upsetting. A scary thing was chasing him, waving its grabbers and gnashing its teeth. Elmore screamed, and the small person bravely got out of bed and clung on to him. "Go away, scary!" shouted the small person. It was nice to have someone there in the dark when the scaries were around. A few days later, Elmore Green was lining up all his precious things so they reached from his bedroom door all the way down the stairs. It was a very long line of things. The small person was amazed. "Ooh," it said. "I could make them reach to the front door if I had some more things," said Elmore. "I have more things," said the small person. "I have at least 5 or 3 things. You can have them." It felt good to have someone who understand why a long line of things was so special. The next evening, Elmore was laughing at the TV. The small person looked at Elmore and then at the TV, and then he laughed too. It was very funny. More funny somehow with 2 people laughing than just 1. Elmore opened his jar of jelly beans. "You can have a jelly bean if you like, Albert." His brother Albert smiled. Elmore smiled back. "Whichever color you like," said Elmore. Except orange. Okay, that was The New Small Person. What'd you guys think? Do you have a younger sibling? What's their name? Okay, our next book is Lola Reads to Leo by Anna McQuinn, illustrated by Rosalind Beardshaw and published by Charlesbridge. Lola's day always ends with a story. Tonight's story is about a little girl and her new baby brother. Lola's mommy is having a new baby too. Lola is going to be a big sister. Lola and her mommy read together a lot. Lola chooses stories the baby will like. Daddy makes new shelves for the baby's things. Lola sorts her books. Some are for the new baby, and some are for keeping. One day, the new baby arrives. It is a brother for Lola. His name is Leo. Lola brings him a soft book for his crib. It is a perfect present. Leo cries a lot. Lola wants to cheer him up, so she tells him a story. It turns out he is just hungry. Lola holds her best bear story while Mommy feeds him. She and Mommy read it together. Sometimes Leo cries when he needs a new diaper. Lola reads him her best potty book. Sometimes he cries in the bath. Lola reads him her best duck story. Sometimes Leo cries when he is tired. Lola reads him her best sleepy story. She sings Leo a song, then he goes to sleep. Lola's new baby brother sleeps a lot. Lola likes to play with her teddies while Leo is sleeping. Being a big sister is a big job. Sometimes Lola helps her mommy. Sometimes she helps her daddy. The new baby keeps everyone busy. They are not too busy to end the day with a story for the best big sister of all. All right, that was Lola Reads to Leo. What'd you guys think? What's your favorite bedtime story? Alright, everybody, thank you for coming to Storytime. Now, just because we're done reading does not mean we have to be done with Storytime. If you come down to the library this week, you can pick up a Storytime kit, which are these fun-filled activity kits that we made to go with the books you read today. Each kit comes with a coloring sheet, a craft, and a tasty recipe that you can make with your grown-ups. Now, this week is something a little special because this week is a mystery craft. This craft requires a lot of teamwork and a lot of grown-up help. So grown-ups, make sure to read the instructions carefully and keep them super secret. To get a kit, you need to come to the Fairfield County Library and look for some crates in the children's section. Now we have two crates, one for Monday story times and one for Wednesdays. So you want to make sure you grab the right kits or you could end up with something completely different than what I just showed you. The kits for this story time are in the group B crate. They're the blue ones. New kits come out whenever there's a new story done, but we might have some kits left from last week if you missed it. It never hurts to ask one of the librarians to go check. Maybe ask for me, Miss Nina. Okay, everybody, thank you for joining me for story time. Once again, my name's Miss Nina, and I hope to see you in the library this week to pick up a story time kit. It's time to say goodbye, but I look forward to seeing you all next time. Bye!